I'm meteorologist Adam Stiles. We're hanging out down here at Harbor Front, and the city is alive. It's time to actually be outside, having a beer out on a patio, or a nice glass of wine, whatever. You can pick your poison. It could even be iced tea, for that matter. Let's talk about what's going to set up, because we're going to get into some summertime temperatures as we get into the middle part of the week. And with our big ridge of high pressure, we have a clear sky in place right now. So quiet tonight. During the day tomorrow, increasing cloud cover on the way. We'll get a brief round of showers into the afternoon. That warm front is starting to push its way just north of Chicago, out through portions of Wisconsin, Milwaukee, and up in toward the Green Bay area. So it's going to be that front that'll bring us the possibility of a brief round of showers, but also the warmer air that's back in through Chicago and Sioux City. That's temperatures into the mid-20s, and with it, there's some humidity. We'll have Humidex values that are going to be settling in close to 32 to 34 as we get toward the middle part of the week. Still pretty lovely out here right now, especially if you're in the sunshine. What we're going to see playing out here over the next couple of days is this warm front stretching across southern Ontario into the early morning hours tomorrow. So showers are possible from Windsor up into Goderich and the Bruce Peninsula. A lot of the moisture is going to come through the northern part of this warm front. So as it actually moves across the GTA, there is a pretty good possibility that it does come through dry. I just want to leave the possibility of a brief shower there along that warm front in the forecast here, if we get just enough instability into the atmosphere to squeeze out a few of those raindrops. We will get into some warmer air during the day on Wednesday and then again on Thursday as winds are going to continue to the southwest, and we're going to stay well out of the colder air until we get into the weekend, when we'll start to bring in a secondary system that'll bring in some more rain, and those temperatures are going to cool off a little bit. So enjoy the warmth here for the next few. On the Futurecast model, you can see 2 o'clock in the afternoon. There's that warm front stretching across the area. The cloud cover builds in. The risk of a spotty shower is there. And then we'll clear things back out as we get toward the evening hours. And we're setting ourselves up for a pretty mild stretch of weather during the day on Wednesday. No problems. A partly cloudy sky expected. There's going to be a little bit of cloud cover here associated with this system. We're not going to get back into another sunny day like this for a bit. Let's talk about how things are going to play out tonight. Our temperatures, they are near 13 degrees. The sky clear, so if you are heading out to the patio, a light jacket will be a very solid move on your part. Overnight, down to 8 degrees. I'll give you caution on the car wash. You could probably get away with it and be fine, but that little spotty shower chance tomorrow, I'm going to leave it up to you to make that decision. We'll see temperatures near 17 degrees by midday with a mix of sun and cloud. Winds are coming in off of the lake, which means it will be cooler here along the lakeshore into the lower double digits, close to 10 to 11 degrees. And then as we head into the afternoon, 18 in the forecast. Looks like the winds are out of the south. The cloud cover's increased, and we have that spotty shower activity coming our way. Here's what your 7-day forecast looks like. It goes from 18 to 29. I have 29 in the forecast there on Wednesday with a Humidex value near 34. 28 on Thursday, Humidex near 32. So it's going to feel like summer, at least for a couple of days. And then by Friday, cooling off quite significantly. 120 degree day over the long weekend with the chance of showers there on Sunday morning. That's a check on the forecast. Enjoy the beautiful evening here across Toronto.